Hello guys, so for today's video, I am here joined by Pumpkin, my Syrian hamster. And for today's video, we are here to talk about the truth about keeping hamsters as pets, as there is a lot of misinformation out there about them. Now, Pumpkin here is my 1-year-old Syrian hamster, and he is actually the first hamster I have ever had. Surprisingly, I never had a hamster growing up like a lot of other kids, so he is actually my first. Now, even though I never owned a hamster until I was almost 18 years old, I'm sure a lot of you guys out there have owned hamsters since you were little kids, as they are a very common kid's pet. Now I'm quickly just going to go ahead and set Pumpkin down on the bed and let him have some free time to exercise and run around as he pleases. One quick thing I want to talk about before we get into the video is my arms. As you can see, I have red dots all over them. No, I'm not sick, I do not have a rash, I do not have chicken pox, I am fine. I just filmed a video with my chameleon, and if you didn't know, chameleons have little sharp nails. And when they climb on you, this is the result. So no, I am fine, I am not sick, I'm okay. I just had a chameleon walking on my arms, okay? Just quick little disclaimer there. So now that all of that is said, let's get into talking about hamsters. We're gonna be talking all about you today, Pumpkin. Video is all about you. So hamsters are by far one of the most common pets out there. Almost everyone you know has probably owned a hamster at one point in their life. They are extremely common, especially for kids. Now, the reason that hamsters are so popular is because they are easy to care for, they don't have that long of a lifespan, so they are not big commitments, and they are quite cheap and easily available. You can go to almost any pet store out there and find a hamster for around $10. No big deal, right? Now, sadly, there is a lot of misconceptions out there when it comes to hamsters and their care. Almost all of us who have owned hamsters at some point in our life have made a lot of these mistakes, including myself. So now let's get into talking about what these common misconceptions are and a lot of the mistakes people make and how you can avoid them in the future. First big thing I can think of when it comes to incorrect hamster care would be the cages. That is the number one thing. So now, if you've ever been to a pet store or you've shopped in an online pet store or Amazon, whatever, you've probably seen those little hamster cages and starter kits that look something like this. A lot of the times, they are just a basic small cage that comes with some of the things you need for a hamster, such as a wheel, a water bottle, a food dish, and maybe more. Almost every single one of these cages that you have seen in the pet stores are not suitable for hamsters. Now, even though hamsters are fairly small animals, as you can see, he is no bigger than the size of my hand, they are not very big, they do need a lot of room. Hamsters are very active animals and they enjoy having room to run, they enjoy having things to play with, things to climb on, things to explore. They are very active, energetic animals. And that is another thing a lot of people don't know. People will buy hamsters and then they barely see them move, so they assume that they're just not very active animals. The thing is, hamsters are fully nocturnal. So due to the fact that they are nocturnal and we don't really see how active they truly are, a lot of people think that they don't really need that much room and that a small cage is fine. Is totally incorrect. As I mentioned earlier, all of those pet store cages that you see are not suitable for hamsters. Typically, most of them will be no more than 2 feet long and 1 foot wide, which is a total of 2 square feet. Now, a cage this size is not at all suitable for a hamster. One single hamster needs a minimum of 450 square inches. Now, this really isn't that big, and even though a lot of the pet store cage options aren't big enough, you still have a lot of other options. What are you doing? Now you may be wondering, if I can't get my cage from a pet store, what do I do? Because obviously you would think that a pet store should probably sell things good enough for the animals they're selling. When it comes to hamster cages, you have so many options for an appropriate sized cage. Now there are ones that can cost as low as $10, and then obviously you can go up in price depending on what you're looking for. One of the easiest and cheapest options when it comes to hamster cages is a DIY bin cage. Now, if you have no idea what a bin cage is, it is basically exactly what it sounds like. It is a cage made out of a plastic storage bin, and that's it. You can go to Walmart or Target or wherever. You can pick up a storage bin for like 10, 15 bucks and turn it into a hamster cage. There are so many videos out there on how to do this, so if that is something you're interested in, I would definitely recommend looking those up. If you plan on getting a bin cage for your hamster, I would recommend getting at least a 110 quart bin or larger. These are typically over 600 square inches of floor space, so they provide enough space for your hamster to be happy and get its exercise and have all kinds of room. Now, aside from bin cages, there are other options such as glass aquariums. A 40-gallon breeder is a very common hamster cage, but you can go bigger if you want. Things like a 40-gallon, a 75-gallon, whatever, those are all really good options for hamsters. Just make sure you have a screen lid if you do choose to use them so that your hamster is still getting a lot of ventilation. And now, aside from bin cages and tanks, there is other things that aren't actually hamster cages that people use as hamster cages. There are things like the IKEA Detolf that is a very commonly used hamster cage, even though it's actually a glass cabinet. So many people use the Detolf as a hamster cage, and that is because it makes a great one. If you have the room for it, it is a great option. The Detolf is over 5 feet long, and I believe it has around 100 square inches of floor space, so it gives your hamster all kinds of room. There are some other options you have, such as more fancy do-it-yourself cages and like building your own cages and stuff like that. I know some people will go and they will turn old furniture into hamster cages, or they will go out and just buy some wood and make their own. So there are so many appropriate options for hamster cages out there. So then this way you can avoid those little tiny plastic ones that they sell at the pet store, because those really are not good for hamsters. The only thing I would ever recommend using those cages for would be such as a travel cage or maybe like a temporary cage. Say for example, if you're like cleaning your hamster's main cage, you can put it in the smaller cage while you're cleaning, something like that. So I would only ever use those as temporary cages because they really do not provide your hamster with enough room to live a happy life. Another reason those small cages are bad has to do with the depth of them. Typically, they come with a plastic tray or a plastic base, something along that lines, that are usually only like 1 to 2 inches deep. This is not really suitable for a hamster because hamsters are burrowing animals, meaning they like to dig, they like to make tunnels, and they like to hide underneath their bedding. So because of this, a hamster should have around 5 inches of bedding or more to burrow in. When you only have a tray that allows for 2 inches of bedding, it's kind of hard to have a 5-inch deep bed, if you know what I mean. So as you can see, because of the size and the depth and just everything about them, these cages really do not make good options. The next thing I'm going to talk about is hamster wheels. There is a lot of incorrect information and incorrect beliefs out there when it comes to hamster wheels. There are many different kinds of wheels out there, such as wire wheels, plastic wheels, there's do-it-yourself wheels, there's a lot of different wheels out there. Now surprisingly, not all of these wheels are safe. For example, we will talk about these metal wire wheels that you see here. Now these are not safe for hamsters. Hamsters need a solid running surface. So the fact that these metal barbed wheels, whatever, have all of these gaps in them is not good for hamsters. They can actually be quite dangerous. All of those little holes and gaps and stuff can be a big risk to hamsters, as they can run on the wheel and then they can get their little feet stuck in it and they can injure them. They can even end up breaking their legs, their toes, their feet. And they can also end up with something called bumblefoot. So there is quite a few different reasons as to why these wheels are not safe. So I would really, really, really recommend avoiding metal and wire wheels. So when it comes to a good wheel for hamsters, you really want something solid. Like a solid plastic wheel is probably your best option, like you see here. There's a lot of different kinds of wheels like this. For example, there's the KT Silent Spinner, there's the KT Comfort Wheel, and then there are things like the Carolina Storm Wheel and Bucket Wheels that people make themselves and sell, and those are all really great options. Now, you can't just go and get any size. You can't just think that your hamster will run on any size wheel because they actually need a lot larger wheels than most people think. A Syrian hamster, such as Pumpkin himself, should probably be using at least a 10-inch wheel. Some Syrians can use an 8-inch if they're a little smaller, but typically a full-grown adult Syrian will probably need at least a 10-inch wheel. Now, this is a lot bigger than people think. Like, when you see a 10 or a 12-inch wheel, you would not think of it as hamster use. You would probably think of it as like a rat or something bigger. When it comes to hamsters running on their wheels, you need to make sure their back is straight. I'm sorry you can't really see, but you need to make sure they have a straight back. If your hamster is on a small wheel, his back will curve, and then that can result in a lot of issues. It can result in spinal issues, which are obviously not good. So when it comes to choosing your hamster's wheel, make sure you are getting one that has a solid base, a solid back, and is appropriate size. That is another issue that a lot of the store-bought hamster kits have. A lot of them come with wheels already included, and a lot of the times these wheels are really small. The next common misconception when it comes to hamsters is their diet. A lot of people don't realize hamsters are omnivores, meaning they can eat both plant and vegetation matter along with animal matter. A lot of people think hamsters really only need to eat nuts and seeds, which is not the case. It is very beneficial to feed your hamster a variety of foods. It is good to have things such as nuts and seeds and grains and vegetables and proteins in your hamster's diet. One protein that they really like are mealworms, so this is a good way to add some protein into their diet and give them a nice treat that they love. Keep in mind that hamsters are in fact, not herbivores, they are omnivores, so they should be eating some kind of animal protein as well as plant-based foods. Another misconception I hear a lot is that hamsters are mean and they like to bite. While every hamster will have a different personality, this is really not the case. As you can see, Pumpkin here is very sweet. He's very tame. He has no issue with me. I've never been bitten before. He is just a great hamster. A lot of them are like this. A lot of people think that it's normal for hamsters to be aggressive and mean and bite and stuff, which usually isn't the case. A lot of the times hamsters are aggressive and mean and they bite when they're not being taken care of properly. So for example, when a hamster is kept in one of those small pet store cages, they become stressed out and they may show that stress by biting. Again, like I said, every hamster is different and some are going to be friendlier than others, but just know that if your hamster is excessively biting or they are excessively mean, this could be a sign of stress rather than just an attitude thing. So I think that is all I'm going to talk about in this video. Hopefully I covered a lot of the basics when it comes to incorrect hamster care. Hopefully from this video you learned that small cages are bad, small wheels are bad, wire wheels are bad, their diets and stuff like that. I hope you learned quite a bit. Obviously I could go on and on because there is just so much more information out there, but I just really wanted to touch on the basics of things today. But hopefully you guys really enjoyed this video. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Also feel free to subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you guys here. Also be sure to check out all of my social media. Everything is just EmmaSam99. It will be in the description below, but everything, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, it's all just EmmaSam99. Check that out. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Pumpkin and I would like to say a big thank you, and we will see you all in my next video.